Everyone, we are Child Rights Awareness Creation Organization, CRACO Nigeria. Wish you a very prosperous new year, and then we hope that this year will be the best year that we've ever had. Thank you for joining us. Okay, so today I'm going to be giving you some tips on parenting. Okay, by the way, my name is Omar Glory, and I'm a premium child educator and a life coach. So stay tuned as I bring you 7 tips on parenting today. Alright, so the first tip I'm gonna give us today is to encourage your child to memorize your phone numbers. Is it how you get them to memorize it? By continuously repeating the numbers so that they get to know it by continuous repetition. Or you can get a number bead, and then put it with a rope, and then like they make the beads and tie it to their wrists, and then they can use that to memorize the number. So you can use it in different forms, so but encourage them to memorize the number, because this will help in the case of emergency. Second tip I'm going to give us today is to make your child feel comfortable and secure always. Make them feel comfortable, let them know that they can trust you, that they can tell you anything, no matter, even if somebody has told them that it's a secret, make them know that they can trust you with it. And then don't break their hearts, don't breach their trust. They trusted you to tell you something, don't ignore them. Make sure that you listen to them always. If a child complains about a particular person, please take note of that person, because they want to even know if you can attend to little matters, or they'll be able to bring big issues to you. So make your child feel secure always. That's the second tip I'm going to give us today. The third tip I'm going to give us today is to not allow anyone call your child my wife or my husband, because some people have taken that aspect and used it to abuse children. Because when you allow them, when you permit it, then they will be able to perform husband responsibilities on your child or wife duties on your child. So that is where this form of abuse is start from, because you say my wife, you call a child my wife, and then the next thing is you are calling to the child to somewhere private, and then the first child feels that my parents was, oh, they understand, they used to say it's our wife, and then I can do anything. So do not let anyone, any adults, call your child my wife, my husband. That's the third tip I'm going to give us today. The fourth tip I'm going to give is to not allow your female child feel comfortable sitting on a man's lap. Always let them know the right values, the sexual values, because if you don't teach them these values, the world will teach them by themselves. So make your child know that this sitting on a man's lap is a no-no. It's a no-no for your female child. So that is the fourth tip I'm going to give us today. Fifth tip I'm going to give us today is to never leave your child for too long with your nanny or your housemaid. Call to check up on your child always. If you peradventure will not be home early, call to check up on that child and know how that child is faring. Don't leave your child in the hands of an housemaid or a nanny for long, and then you can't call to check up on that child. Then if you're able to call, you know that the child will be able to trust you and know that, okay, my mommy has got my back on this. So but if you ignore them and leave them in the hands of a nanny, you are apparently making the nanny more comfortable. They are making your child more comfortable with nannies than you. Okay, so when you leave the house, don't stay too long. Or if you are still going to stay too long, make sure you put a call through to your child to know how they are faring. The sixth tip I'm going to give us today is when your child speaks, believe them. Listen to them first and then believe what they say. Because if you don't believe them, I bet you they will not come again to tell you what happened to them. So believe them, listen to them. It is very, very important that you listen to whatever your child has to say. Even if it's talking gibberish, just listen to them. They want your attention. When you're able to listen to even the minute things that they have to say, they'll be able to come and tell you bigger things. So listen to your children. Very, very important. Most parents don't know how to listen. They just want to intrude. They just want to talk. Listen first before you interrupt what they have to say. Learn to listen to your child. And then last but not the least, the seventh tip that I'm going to give us today is that you should praise your child for reporting events. When your child comes, "Mom, Dad, I did this, I did that, I'm sorry." Please discipline that child if you need to, but then praise the child for telling the truth. Because most times we know how to discipline well when somebody comes to tell you, "I did this," but then when they are lying, you still the same discipline. So what's the point of us saying the truth when I can't lie and then not get anything, and lie and get away with it rather? So praise that child for telling the truth. Sometimes you even need to ask, "Okay, because you told the truth, I would not do this to you. I would not do that to you." But make sure that you praise that child. The next time, the child will not feel want to come and lie. But when you keep telling them, "You lie, you did," even if the child is even telling the truth, you still say, "The child is lying, he's lying." So praise your child for reporting events. Reporting events, they'll come and tell you more, I bet you. So that is the seventh thing. Thank you for joining us today. We hope to see you next time, because we'll be having more of this. We'll be giving you more tips on parenting and all that.